For more updates, click on subscribe and click on bell button for latest notifications. Hi friends, welcome to Tech ARK IT YouTube channel. My name is Ravi. In this video session, we are going to see that how to move a LVM from one server to another server, or how to migrate one LVM from one server to another server without losing the data.
Like, share, comment, and subscribe.
So that is the agenda of this video. So how we can move that, let's see this process. So I am using over here is that the VMware version. So here I have two servers, one is CentOS and one is a Red Hat one, and I'm moving this LVM in between one from one server to another server. So here I'm doing, what I'm doing is that I'm just going to add a new disk, and I will create the LVM top of this disk and move that disk to the another server and activate the LVM over there. So in this case, I'm just taking the 5GB in space. Okay, so here I'm just saying that LVM disk. Now new disk is added to this server. So in order to do activate or scan for the new hardware changes, you have to run this echo scan command, the SCSI scan command. Let's run it. So let's run this command over here, and now let's see this fdisk-l, and you can see that new disk. This is a new disk, 5GB is added over here. Let's create the LVM using this disk. fdisk /dev/sdb. Now create the new partition, and it's a primary partition, and the partition number 1, and I'm using the entire space for this partition. You can just print out this that is a LVM, and now change that type to 8E, which is Linux LVM partition. So you can see this this is a Linux LVM file system, which has been changed. The type has been changed to an Linux LVM. Now save that and update the kernel using /the device name. Okay, now you can see this fdisk-l /dev/sdb, which will you can list out this, the partition 1 is created with the Linux LVM. Now create the pv create /dev/sdb1, and the pv has been created. Now create the vg create vg name. So I'm just providing the vg migrate, something like this, and providing the pv path, and vg has been created. Let's create the lv create -n and provide the lv name, and I'm going to provide it's 100% free space. I'm just using 100% complete space. I'm just using, and provide this vg name. It's a vg migrate. Now the lv has been created. You can see this lv display /dev vg migrate lv0. You can see this, the 5GB LVM has been created. Now I'm going to make this file system mkfs.ext4/dev vg migrate and lv, and the file system is going to be created over here. Let's create one directory, let's say vg mgr, and mount that LVM, newly created LVM, to this vgmgr directory /vgmgr. Now you can see this 5GB data LVM has been created. Let's go ahead into that vgmgr and create some files. Okay, so I'm just saying that touch testing from 1 to 100 dot txt files will be created. 100 files has been created over here, and I'm just adding some data to any of the file, maybe 21, like testing data for after migration, anything like this. So just like our data is there on these files after migrating also, to verify that. Okay, so these are the files, and VG has been created, and VG is 5 GB. So in this server I have created the VG, and the VG has been successfully created. Now let's go ahead to the another this server and unmount this one and migrate this VG to the another server and import over there, so that our VG should come as it is without any issues. So first of all, we have to unmount this one. Umount slash maybe I can use this putty session, so that it gives much umount and slash vgmgr. Now you can see that there is no file system. Okay, and remove that one. And now what you have to do is that you have to inactivate the VG, the existing VG you have to inactivate. In order to do that, VG change is the command, -an, and in the sense inactivate that VG and provide the VG name. So VG has been deactivated. Let's export this VG over here, VG export, and use the VG name. Okay, VG migrate. So the VG has been exported successfully. So now VG has been exported successfully. We just have to shut down the machine, or maybe you can unmount those disks. So to safely remove is that I'm just shutting down this server and remove the disk from this server and reattach to the other server and import the disk over there. So in order to do that, so I'm just using that systemctl power off. So this system is going to be powered off, and I can go to the VMware over here, so which is going to be powered off. Now you can go to settings and remove these disks. Okay, so remove this disk from this and say okay, and now go to the server and attach the disks to the server. So now add and say next and next, and here use an existing virtual disk. So the disk is already there. So now I'm just going to browse that one, and here is in CentOS and LVM disk. This is the one, and attach these disks over here. So the disk has been attached. Now let's go to the server. So this is the server over here, and scan for new hardware changes. So is the command. Let's see that. Okay, now fdisk-l, you can see this new disk has came, sdb1 over here, and now you can see this pvs, you can see this the pv, and vg migrate is the vg name is already came over here, but you can see this A attribute is AX. Okay, which means that that is an exported VG over here. So now what you have to do is that we have to scan for any PVs. PV scan, just run this one so that you can find out this is an exported VG. So you can see this clearly, that that is an exported VG from somewhere else. So now import this one, VG import, and provide the VG name. So this is the VG name I'm just providing over here. Now you can see this volume group migrate, VG migrate is successfully imported. Now you can see this VGs, you can see this VGs, and but the LV we have to activate it back. Then the VG import has been came back. Activate the VG volume group name. So in order to do that, now VG change -ay and provide the VG name. So the VG name is VG migrate and enter. Now you can see this one logical volume is active. Now you can see this LVS and this is the LV0 LVM1. So you can see this, the attributes has came back. Now you can create the new directory over here. I can say that mkdir that migrated VG, something like this, and I'm going to mount that one /dev/ VG migrate LV0 and I'm going to mount it to here. And now you can see this DFFNH, the VG is came back successfully. And now let's go to this migrated VG and see this, the data is there. And see that the testing 21, we have created some data over there. So the data is intact, nothing is impacted. Now you can see that the VG is migrated from one server to another server successfully without any issues. That's how you can migrate the LVM from one server to another server without losing your data. That's about it, guys. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned. Please subscribe to the channel for more upcoming videos and courses. Please follow us on social networking sites. If you have any technical related questions, you can ask.